My name's Tashan Miyar, and I'm the choreographer and director of Entity Allstars. It's, words can't describe it. I mean, everyone's looking nice, everyone's here, everyone's happy. So I go to cinema a lot, and to come to cinema in this surrounding, it's like, it's mesmerizing. I'm just so happy to be here, so happy that we've made it, and so happy that we get to share our story and our journey with the whole world. So the film's basically about us. It's about our life, it's about our rehearsals, it's about our training, it's about the shows and the competitions, the ups and the downs and the highs and the lows that we went through to get to where we needed to get to those world championships. It shows the parents, that the parents have been amazing. I've got so much love for the parents, because if it weren't for them, the kids wouldn't be able to come down and do what they do. So it's just about how much work it takes and how much dedication it takes to be the best, not even just for everyone, just for yourself, to be the best for yourself. Well, we would train like at least 3 times a week, and on a Saturday we was training like at least 5 hours every Saturday. And because of things that were going on, things that were stressing us out, things that were, like when the odds were against us, it pushed us even more. Like choreographically, there's a lot of times where I was like feeling down. I was at my lowest actually when we was doing this film because of the stuff that was going on. And I had to push that out through the choreography, and the kids were amazing. The kids were supportive, and yeah, it just all came out in the end. And I'm just really, really proud of it. I know it might sound silly because the film's obviously called Streetdance Family, but it is family. It is the support. It is from the parents to myself to the kids. It's like a circle that goes round. Like we all help each other. I teach the kids and I mentor the kids, and the kids go back to their parents and the parents give them advice. The parents come to me and then they feed me advice and say, you know what, Tashan, thank you for doing this, or you maybe could do this or do that. And it's just a whole big circle and a whole big family. And when you've got that support system, you've got positive people that are surrounding you and are helping you, those positive role models, you can achieve anything, whether it's dancing, music, arts, any job you want to do, any dream you want to follow. If you've got amazing people and supportive people around you, the sky's the limit. If you want to get into street dance now, say find out if there's any local groups or community centres that do street dance. Research online. There's so many things online. There's so many places. Or you can hit me up. unityDanceUK@hotmail.com. I've got a new studio in Beckton, East London. So if you want to come and train with the Entity All-Stars, or you want to be a part of us, or even just come down for fun, then hit me up and then we'll make some magic work. In August, we're going to go to America to a competition called HHI. Like, it's the biggest world championships out there. So we're going to go over there and represent UK. We're also going to put on our own show in theatres. So it could be coming to a theatre near you. And just making them grow and helping them. They're all getting older now. They're all doing exams and stuff. And they're doing well in school. So it's just about helping them grow. Some of them want to be dancers, want to be teachers. So I'm helping them to choreograph, to become teachers, to then teach the younger generation of Entity and Unity. So yeah, the future's bright for all of us. I just want to say thank you. Every single person that has come to my rehearsal studio or come to my class and given me the inspiration and given me the time to help them and to help myself, and everyone that supported, everyone that's voted for us when we was on TV, for the judges and for the that's marked us, for everyone that's given us even constructive feedback, just thank you. I love you all. Parents and the kids, especially the kids, I love them from the bottom of my heart, and I will never stop, and we will never stop.
I'm Lewis Platt.
How does it feel to be a part of this film?
Yeah, it's cool, because like, we've never really done anything like this, so it's different, but it's quite cool to do it. Like, with the red carpet and all the things like that, so I like it, yeah.
What's it like competing on that stage at that world championship level?
Yeah, it's mad, because you see all the other people performing and doing all their stuff, and then you think, oh my God, like, I'm against that, and it's cool, but we really enjoyed it. There were these people, they were from Canada, and they were just amazing. Like, everything they did, their flips, tricks, formations, everything was really good. So they were like our biggest competition, but yeah, it was cool.
Why do you think that street dance has exploded in the last 5-10 years? Why do you think it captures people's imagination so much?
I don't know, for me it's probably just all the films that have come out, like Step Up and Street Dance, and everyone started enjoying them, so that's probably why it's so big now.
In terms of you guys, what have you got planned for the future? Where do you want to go?
I'm not 100% right now. We have like shows and just little things like that, but maybe some other competitions like this soon, but I'm not sure. thanks for supporting, and if you're watching the film, hope you enjoy it.
Hi, I'm Beau from Entity Allstars.
It's fantastic to have you here tonight. Can you tell us how the film came about?
Ethan, the producer's son, was in our team, and they just saw like the journey we were going through, and they said they wanted to document it, so they did. We're a street dance crew from East London, and we compete all over the country. 2 years ago, we competed in the World Championships, and that's when they documented the film, and yeah.
And what was it like, obviously being on an incredible journey like that, but also knowing that it was being filmed and the whole world was going to get to see that?
To be honest, at first it was a bit like, oh my God, we're being filmed every day of our life. But then like when it got to the end of it, it was like, oh, like it became natural to us. And then it didn't really come around till about 2016 when I actually realised it was going to come out like on a big screen. So yeah.
What does it feel like being a part of a competition like that, a big event like the World Championship?
Oh, it's really scary. At first it was really scary, but then, because I've done it a few times now, it sort of, you get a grip of it and then you like sort of know what's going on and you meet people from other countries, so it's really good, yeah.
Does competing in an event like that cause you to raise your game dancing-wise?
Oh yeah, definitely. I've been dancing for 12 years now and I've never danced the standard that I'm dancing now, so... I just think because, like singing, it shows people's passion, and it's like really a really good way to show your love and for something. So yeah, it can show emotion.
It's a controversial question, but amongst the group, who's the best dancer and why?
There isn't a best dancer. There's always like we're all good in our own different ways. So yeah, we have a lot of shows coming up. Some of the people from their team are going to America this year to compete in the HHI. So, yeah, it's going to be a tough year.
Before you leave us, do you have a message to the fans that have supported you all the way along that journey?
Thank you for supporting us. We love you all.
My name's Jordan Shepherd. It's exciting. Like, I've never been in a film. I've never been on this side of dance. Like, having a movie directed about you is different. There's a lot of... like ups and lows in the film, but the ups were like the thing that made us want to go. It's just the whole experience of the film.
Why do you think people have fallen in love with street dance? Why do you think it captures people's imagination so much?
I think it's because there's a lot of like upcoming youth and like younger generation, and they're all involved in street dance or like more new styles of dance. To make a team work, it's all about helping each other. Like that's all there is to it, and dedication.
And in terms of preparation for this competition, were there specific styles of dance or new routines, new moves that you especially had to work on?
Yeah, there was loads of different types of styles inside of the hip-hop genre. It took a lot of training to master them, to be able to like get where we got in the film, but it's all worth it. That's what helped us get there. More films, to become known like further in the industry, so not just dancers see us, more general public kind of thing.
And in terms of dancers, who are the dancers that inspired you growing up?
It was my coach, Tashan. Like I saw him dancing and it was amazing, so I wanted to follow it. If I could see a fan right now, I'd probably say thank you. Like it's got us here on the red carpet, it's pretty amazing, yeah. Thank you.
Really proud. The guys, the kids work so hard for so long. And it's amazing to be here, to go through the journey, to get to travel abroad, to watch your kids do what they love doing. It's just great. Really, really great.
Who or what was it that gave you that passion for dance to begin with?
I don't really know. I used to dance when I was younger, and then I went to Entity, and then it went from there, really. And then it got more fun.
What was it like competing at the World Championships? An amazing platform to be a part of.
It was really good. I actually probably sat there. I probably sat there the most of the time and watched all of the dancers, which... you could probably say it's sad, but at least I watched them all. So when I watched the film and they show all the other dancers, I can remember all of them. I think it's because people probably do stuff that's different now. I think before people would just, it would just be regular street dance, whereas now, you know, there's different styles, people see it more, there's, you know, different, people do themes, you know, just all stuff like that really. I think before people didn't really see it for what it was.
And there's more TV shows and stuff like that and dance competitions and, you know, the more you see, the more you do, doesn't it? So really, I think that's how, why, whatever, how it works.
What are you hoping that an audience takes away, specifically from the experience of watching this film?
The roller coaster, the hours the children have, the endless hours the children put in, how much of a family we all are.
And love your family.
Just very, very, very special team, very special. And, you know, we had to come up against a lot of hardship, a lot of injustice. And we conquered.
Hi, I'm Adam Tyso, co-director, camera and editor on the project.
Can you talk about the logistical challenges of capturing a story like this on camera?
It was crazy. We were literally running like, it was just following the action, and one thing happened after another. So we would literally go into the competition space and we wouldn't stop moving probably for about 8 hours, you know, solidly, just following action as it was happening. So yeah, it was really hard, but we had small lightweight kit, which makes it a lot easier, of course, nowadays. Well, I hope we captured the journey so you get a feel of what it's really like to be in the competitions and the amount of emotion and hard work and just graft that everybody puts in to achieve, you know, what they achieve. Because actually, we tried to build the film so you got to a point where during the final moments, you really feel what we were all feeling at that moment. That was the idea. So I hope that comes across and that people really get a sense of the passion and the emotion of the dancers.
How important do you feel films like this have been in catapulting street dance into mainstream popular culture in the last 10 years?
Well, I think a lot of obviously the street dance franchise has done a huge amount, but a lot of people, we've shown a lot of people in the street dance world, the film, and they were all really blown away and loved the fact that we've kind of captured something that's a bit more real. It's a bit less glitzy, and we've got the real, I think you get the real story, you get the real sense of the work and the pain and all of the other, I suppose the passion that goes into it, because it really is, it's something that they all love to do.
Hi, I'm Debbie Shooter. I am the director-producer of Street Dance Family. We came across this street dance crew when our son, Ethan, joined the group. And he joined the group, he'd been dancing for a while, he then joined Entity. We were going backwards and forwards to Barking, where he was training, and we came across these parents and these families and thought, you know what, something interesting's going on here, we need to start filming them. So we started filming them. We really didn't have any idea what was the journey that we were going on with them, but we just had a hunch it looked like it was going to be interesting. And then as we started and as it got going, it just got more and more interesting and exciting, and we couldn't really stop until we got to the end. It was really, really difficult, to be honest. There was one of the most difficult things was that there were so many people that we were following, because obviously within the crew there's like 18 kids, which means 18 families, and obviously that's a lot of people to cover. So when we were actually in the competitions, because this is a competition crew, it's a very specific thing, a competition crew. And I think it's the same whether you're doing swimming or any kind of competition. You're dealing with the people who are doing the competitions, but you're also looking at the mums and the parents and the audience who are supporting their people doing the competition. And obviously that means that you have to be in a million places all at the same time, and it is really difficult. It was hard. It was really, really quite difficult. I don't want to give anything away, but there are a lot of emotional moments in the film. There really are. It's a really emotional roller coaster. So there were lots of moments where They felt really heartfelt and both happy and sad. And obviously, by the time we got into those nitty-gritty moments, we really knew the people so well that we were filming, because we'd spent so long with them, that we really, you know, felt emotionally involved with them, really. So there were lots of really beautiful moments, but I don't really want to say what they are, because obviously you'd have to get that if you saw the film. I think what I want audiences to take away from the film is that stuff is possible if you really want it. If you really have the hunger and if you really, really want something, you can actually achieve things. And it doesn't matter how big or how small, you can do things if you have the belief and you have the passion and if you just keep going and don't let obstacles stand in your way. That's what I would say.